Hey everybody, it's Mr. Mill here. So we are going to discuss in this lesson today what the difference between communism and capitalism is, so you understand kind of what I'm talking about when we start to read Inside Out and Back Again so you're not confused. So learning targets for today are I can understand what communism and capitalism is, and I can understand the similarities and differences between communism and capitalism. These are really big words, but they're really important to our story, so that's why we're going to go through them. All right, so the idea of capitalism is it's an economic system where the government does not control any sort of business unless it's an emergency or companies break the law. And here's the nice thing about that is that right now we're living through a time period that's kind of crazy. And with the coronavirus and everything, that there have been companies that the government has taken control of to make sure they don't go under. But that doesn't happen very often. But like, that's a good example. So in capitalist countries where there's capitalism, businesses are created by individuals and people are able to pick and choose within reason what kind of jobs they want. I say within reason because anybody can start up their own business. That makes sense. It would not make sense if somebody was trying to be a doctor when they had a degree in like history or English or, you know, something that was a medical science. So there are limits, but within reason, you're able to do what you want to do as long as you do like are educated enough. So America and most countries around the world have capitalism built into their country society. So we are a capitalist country. I would say 90 to 93% of the world is full of capitalism. So keep that in mind, please. So it's just what our country is like. Communism is another sort of economic system. It's a little different. In this economic system, the economy is controlled by the government. So instead of business people creating businesses, the government creates businesses. The government also determines what companies are needed. So for example, is if the government of a communist country feels that there's a lot of people not wearing shoes, they will just be like, you know what? We're going to build a factory that makes nothing but this kind of shoe. All right. So that is what they do. And as well, the government tells people what kind of jobs people can have. So in school, if there is a need for a lot of scientists in a communist country, you're going to be going to school and learning about how to be a scientist. You don't get a choice in the matter typically because the government feels that it's more important. So that is a difference between capitalism and communism. Also, in communist countries, the government provides everything for everybody. So everybody gets houses, food, clothes, and et cetera. It's all free, but then it's the government. People don't really own private property. So that is the difference. So, but we're going to talk about communism more in depth because we don't have communism here and it's a foreign concept to you, I'm sure. I'm sure you've heard the terms. I just want you to understand. So when we're reading the story, you understand what's going on. So communism itself started in the 1840s when a German writer named Karl Marx, he was living in England. He was actually ran out of his country because he wrote this book. He wrote this book called The Communist Manifesto. In this book, Karl Marx says that in order for there to be peace and prosperity across the world, everything had to be equal. So everybody had to be equal. Everybody would be the same class, no matter of religion, race. Everyone would be the same. But to be able to do that, the working class people, like the poor people and working class, would have to overthrow the governments of the world, as well as get rid of private companies and get rid of the rich people. He believed that private companies, religious institutions, and rich people and government workers and things like that, they had power over the lower classes, like the middle class like we're in, and the poor classes that are in society, that they were the ones that needed to overthrow the government. In the book, Marx said that a perfect society had no government, religion, or private companies, and that everybody was equal. So he wrote this book, and nothing really came of it for a really long time until World War I. During World War I, there was actually a communist revolution in Russia. So in World War I, basically, Russians had no rights and were starving to death. There was a lot of poor people living in Russia, and there was a king that ran everything, and he ruled things with an iron fist. He wasn't very nice to people. He killed a lot of people, and also the Russians themselves didn't want to fight in World War I. And what happened is that it made the population very mad, and these people were reading this Communist Manifesto book, and they started to become communists, and then they overthrew the government. Unfortunately, though, it didn't become a communist, like a pure communist country like Karl Marx said it was going to be. Instead, this man right here named Joseph Stalin, he controlled everything in Russia. He was kind of a dictator, and Russia was a communist country that lasted until 1991. So it lasted for a very long time. And Karl Marx did not, you know, understand, because he wasn't alive at this time, that people would take advantage of the idea of communism, basically become dictators. So the country of Russia for the last like 50 to 70 years was controlled by a dictator with the Communist Party there. So once the Russian Revolution ended, there was panic around the world. A lot of people were scared of people like Joseph Stalin, like governments and business people around the world, because the Russian Revolution was really violent. Millions and millions of people died for that. However, though, there was a lot of optimism, too. There's a lot of people around the world, poor people, that looked to the inspiration of the revolution. And there were other communist revolutions, which we will talk about later. But right now in 2020, there are six communist countries left. Russia, ironically, is not a communist country anymore, which we'll talk about later. The ones that are around still are China. That's the biggest one. North Korea, Cuba, Laos, and Vietnam. Only one of those countries is near us. That's Cuba. China, North Korea, Laos are all in Asia and very far away from us. So in these countries, the governments control everything still. There are a lot of human rights violations in these countries right now as well. And for the most part, outside of China, the United States does not work with other communist countries, because we are typically enemies against communist countries. But China is an exception, because they do a lot of business with us. Thank you for watching this video.